while, went and got that, got us something to eat, and this, that, and another. Now, I just got back a little while ago. How about it?
Well, you're just in time to put the hammer on old Harry Lefthaney there. I'm glad you came in here, George. We wouldn't have anybody to key on the old cleft lift there if you weren't in there right now.
That damn Q-tip does that all the time, don't it?
Yeah, he can't help himself. He likes the abuse. And he likes to come in there and have people like you and me key on him there. Makes him feel like he's having rough sex. And you know he loves rough sex. He's a sinner.
Man, he damn sure does, don't he?
Yeah, he likes that. He likes that Johnson baby oil smeared all through his little furry suit. And then he's got that little peephole cut in the butt of it there so he can have easy access.
I heard that, Bob. I heard that. Ah, boy, I tell you something.
There's nothing more Haney likes than to have a good hard dick shoved up into the hole in his little furry suit and send him home to mama.
Oh, Lord, Daniel.
Yeah, well, he likes it.
You put your heart on him.
These are grown men, too.
You know, Haney likes that. Haney likes that little thing in the little poop chute there. That's what keeps him going every day.
What? What is it they call him? I say Q-tip. It ain't Q-tip. Something else.
Got a stick shoved in the bottom of him.
What the hell's it? What is his name? I forgot.
Haney?
Yeah, Haney. Yeah.
Yeah, that's his
what
name.
What the hell caused him to do that
he's
to me? I ain't done nothing wrong to him.
That can't really talk properly. That's out there every day. You know, Quirman, me, and you, and everybody. You know Haney.
Yeah, I know him. But I ain't done nothing to him to cause him to do that.
Yeah, that he is. When you just stick the head in and it start to make penetration, that's when that goes off.
When you put your hand back through that button-up flap and the ass cheeks of that furry suit.
That's right. You push it up far enough, it goes out the flap in the front by the face.
I don't know why the hell he does it to me, because I ain't done nothing to him.
Oh, he loves you, George. Haney wants you. He's got a hankering for what's hanging down there between your legs.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Well, I wouldn't much do him no good.
I know it, but a boy can wish. A boy can wish. Don't break his dreams.
Yeah, that's all you can do is damn wish. But that's all it is to it to me.
There's nothing that excites Haney more than thinking of he's got a new penis there to introduce to his tongue and lips there. You know, he likes variety. Ain't nothing Haney likes more than a nice, bulging, throbbing cock.
Good damn thumb one. I drink Sprite or Coke or something like that, but I ain't no darn alcoholic.
Nah, don't give him a Coke. Just pop a top on a nice fresh can of cock, and Haney will be right there.
Oh, my God, Danny.
Right down, buddy. I got a little spotted dick for him right here.
Yeah, I'm just waiting to get that other thing of mine fixed up. And damn him, I'll cause him to step on somebody. He wants to be that way. He thinks he got something. I will show him what a little something is.
Alcoholic alert. He's still retaliating there. Haney was keyed down for a little while trying to make his point. He doesn't like everybody knowing that he likes Dick. So when I bring it up there, he feels like he has to ramble on endlessly, hoping that maybe he'll cover up what I'm saying. But Haney loves a nice spotted dick.
He must not hear me, Dan.
Well, he can't hear anybody while he's keyed down, rattling like K1LEM.
There's a truck coming, man, over.
He's...
I haven't got any indictments.
Now, I don't know about Joe. I'm trying to get Joe to owe up about Pamela's nice big tits and her snapper, but he doesn't want to let loose the information. Joe's being coy.
Yeah, there you go, Georgie. There's another example right there.
Exactly, Joe.
It's just foul. I mean, that's like a 12-year-old boy acting up.
Yeah, it sounds like Daniel just made his first visit to a pool hall.
12-year-old boy acting tough by saying that nasty stuff.
He lied like the child molester that he is. That cotton-picker came in here and lied like a dog. He promised me and he promised you that we were going to have indictments. That was what, 2 years ago?
Okay.
Hey, Joe, meet me on 43.
You think the band's open on 43?
Yeah, goes away here, too.
I wish the people would just love each other.
It's good to hear you in there, man.
Okay, when it opens
I
up.
I have to be the bearer of bad news. Michael McGrigian, N2FUV, over at 3023 Panorama Point Way. I hate to be the bearer of bad news of this, but
that's all he does. He talks about four operators. He's got four operators on the mind.
Everything else he said on the radio.
I think people should just love each other.
I think you may be imprinted in his DNA.
Good evening, K9RSY.
We're trying to be model hams today. Don't use bad language.
Yeah, and disgusting stories about the name of a genitalia of a female. You know, that's pretty bad.
Well, I think Raymond's decided just to stay on 75 meters.
Well, that's because Joe went to 38 and 22 and is squirming him every night there.
I don't know.
Joe, you left that part out. Yeah, Joe left out the fact that he's on
38 and 22
every night squirming poor Raymond.
I don't engage in scatological discussions.
No room to talk. Joe hates Raymond as much as you do.
It's a very sad situation down there in Florida.
Poor little Joe. But you know what? I don't know if you have any more influence over Joe than I do.
Well,
I doubt it. But
yeah, you make
could you find
point.
Out if Miss Fanbury got me a set of knockers and a sniper on it just for me?
You know
I've been waiting and waiting and waiting, and Joe will not be honest about it.
That's a terrible situation down there.
Yeah, that fella has chiggers in his head.
On salmon.
He's got chiggers in his hair.
Chiggers in his hair?
Yeah, those fellas out there that are cursing, using all that foul language, the reason they do that is because they get those chiggers in their hair, and the poison from the insect basically weakens their brains.
On salmon.
Oh, my God, listen to that.
Do to me what you want to do, you would asphyxiate on salmon. Hey, Gary, if I came over to your house and I'd let you do to me...
It's like he's screaming from the bottom of the pile.
Asphyxiate on salmon.
Some people never made it in life. The biggest achievement some people made is they got their ham radio license.
Yeah, I got my license there. I went down to the ham club. Went down to the ham club and I bought two cases of beer. And if you bring two cases of beer, you get a general. You get a general. If you bring four cases of beer, you get yourself an extra.
Yeah, all you got to do is pay off some of the lowlifes that did the test in some of these places, and you bought in.
Well, especially when you take your license in the club. The club has three members, like Dan. When Dan took the test, I think the club had three members. Over?
I heard about that.
I think they were hard up for members.
You would asphyxiate on salmon.
Boy, I guess as you get a 33% increase in your number of club members when one guy comes and takes the test. Over.
You could make a simple on KZ80's ass there, partner.
You would asphyxiate on salmon. Yeah, but I mean, that shit would be poured out of every orifice and every layer of flap all the way down to the neck you don't have. Every orifice and every layer.
That don't work no more.
Yeah, but I mean, that shit would be poured out of every orifice and every layer of flap.
You could make a pimple on KZ80's ass.
On salmon. To do, you would asphyxiate on salmon.
Dad.
Why?
Hey, Ron, why'd you let Captain Dave take our frequency last night?
Oh, there's little HC1DD there. He's calling you, Ronnie.
Come in. What does that mean? That just means that you're not a very good radio operator. Would you not agree?
Well,
oh,
you
I
tell
had
him,
to take
Ronnie.
A phone call.
You tell him about not being
Dave
a very good
elbows.
Well, that's Joe Italiano, and you need to talk to him like he's a Joe Italiano.
Who got beat up by a policeman for possession of narcotics.
Oh, my gosh, not beat up.
I don't know. Nobody else was talking to him. He was just talking to the guy on the phone patch, and I just thought, that's third party. You're not allowed to do that.
Why are you talking
to
me?
Yeah, you're probably going to get in trouble for it.
Flat. Joe Italiano doesn't like you. Joe Italiano thinks you're a hockey puck. He thinks you're a stupid Canadian. Of course, I do, too, but nevertheless, Joe feels the same way.
That's a good excuse. Go with that one. I was on the phone. I missed it.
Poor Joe Italiano hates you, Ron. He thinks you're a ridiculous, skinny little twit up in Canada with the mentality of a fifth or sixth grader. And despite how ridiculous Joe Italiano is, I'm afraid he's pretty much accurate on that evaluation.
I'll hold it down for as long as I have the energy.
Oh,
okay,
my.
I might not be there till about 3 or 4 in the morning.
I'll be fast asleep by then. 3 or 4 in the morning is like what? It's almost 5 o'clock here.
But Joe Italiano talks to you because Joe Italiano doesn't have anyone else to talk to, Ronnie.
Well, the people that talk to you, Dan, want to...
And the little guy with the robotic voice there, number one, you couldn't make a pimple on KZ80's ass.
Hey, Ron, did,
and number two... That was
LEM
pretty much
get
your
his,
chicken shit for doing recordings
over.
And not using your own call sign. So hit the road.
And I heard you attacking Jerry and whoever it was.
No. I wasn't attacking. I was counterattacking. Dookie was slandering me again.
Right. He could hear your little obnoxious, nasally, queer tones. He just couldn't hear them.
I was counterattacking. Dookie was using my name. He was talking to. He was talking to that other guy. I always forget his name, and he was using my name and saying I
was
a bad ham.
I
can't believe it.
We were only butt buddies for a day or two. I never really asked his name.
I got a hammer that stands.
Joe doesn't ask anybody his name, you know, when he plants it in one. He, you know, unless he's a return,
and he starts saying bad things about
return supplier there.
Joe
might remember if you come by and he services you there once or twice.